walked around like I was missing, cause I was missing you. I was looking for a reason, but couldn't find the truth. Never knew it could be different, and I ran into you. You make falling feel like flying, I'm tripping into you. Even when I was broken and hopeless, you walked in and things changed. I realized you're all that I want. You say the word and I follow. I won't let anything get in my way. Nothing, no, nothing can stop. Now I'm seeing all the colors, you open up my eyes. Did it in a moment, my darkness in a light. You gave me purpose, I'm chosen. Without you, I'm nothing, I realize you're all that I want. You say the word and I follow. I won't let anything get in my way. Nothing, no, nothing can stop me.
Thank God we did it. get my mind racing, and I can't seem to win all these crazy thoughts and feelings. It's like it never ends until your voice breaks through my noise. I know I'm not alone, not alone. You fight my battle.
We are City Impact Youth. We believe Jesus is for everyone. We will do whatever it takes to see our generation saved. We are fearless in living out our purpose. We love God. We love people. This is our generation. This is our mission. This is our time.
Welcome to our very first YouTube channel. Whoa!
So good to have you guys with us here tonight. We are seeing you guys coming through on the comments.
Come on, keep coming, keep it coming.
We'll give you some shout outs. Sup, Gino?
Gino. We got some shout outs from David.
Totally,
David?
Oh. From Hastings.
Hastings. Hastings is in the house. Also, Armini, I think you were telling us, about our mask. I've got something for you after this, Armini, so watch out for your comments, okay?
Well, Pastor Joseph is on the chat. What's up?
Awesome. We got Joseph. Also, who else do we have here? Talia.
Nice. Greece. Talia Griesel.
Nice to have you on board.
Got the loud girls here. Nikki Cortez.
Hey, guys, we've got an amazing night set up for them, eh? Amazing night. We've got something pumping tonight. We'll keep going with the shout-outs.
Lois. Hey, Lois. Mark Allen. Hey, nice to see you.
Mark Allen.
So many good people on tonight. Look at that.
So many. Keep it
first
coming, guys.
First time and so many people loving it. 61 people with us
61.
Here tonight.
61. Come on, guys. Let's push it up to 100.
Pump it.
Spread the word. Push it up to 100.
Don't forget to subscribe. Press the little bell so you're notified when
we go
live.
Yes.
It's going to be good. Pastor Nick, there's your shout-out.
Nice. Awesome.
Frost.
We also got Frost.
Don't know who that is, but we'll give you a shout-out.
Welcome, Frost.
Appreciate
good
you coming
to have
out
you with
tonight.
Us, joining us.
It's good.
Nice. Keep it coming. We also got Samuel Woolocks.
Nice.
Nice to have you also join us tonight.
He's a good drummer, that guy.
Hope you're going to enjoy yourself tonight. Also, we've got Crystal Kendon.
Allegra, her daughter. Allegra.
Oh, nice. Awesome.
We appreciate that you joined us tonight, Allegra. Love you, girls.
Awesome.
You go.
Oh, look at that. We're in sync tonight, okay? Very first time. Also, I think if you can mention the campus you're from.
Yes.
Put it in there. Let us know
which
campus.
We want to know where you're at. And if you're part of the Loud crew, make sure you hit us in the comments. We want to see how many of you are here tonight.
Come on.
We are stoked. Surely. Yes. Azon
awesome.
Gaming.
Should we keep reading some out?
Where are you guys from? North Shore.
North Shore.
Yes.
Mount Wellington.
Where you at? There it is.
There we go.
Rotorua's
in the house.
Azon. Chanelise is with us tonight. I love this. So many good people on tonight.
Anyone
we are
from
stoked.
Out west and Botany.
Yeah, where they
are. We want to see that coming up.
We see you.
We know you're out there.
Yeah, we have your one and only top fave, Daniel Tankard, with us tonight.
Yes,
so he's
going to
be popping in a little bit later, eh?
You'll see him tonight.
Yeah, it's going to be good. West side. Oh, I don't know how to do that.
Oh, should we do a bit of side and signs tonight, Holly?
I don't know how to do it.
Keep it coming.
Nice.
So, if this is your very first time tuning in, which it is actually because this is our very first time.
Yeah.
I want you to, if you have any shout outs to anyone, your friends, put it in there so we can give a shout out to them as well.
Yeah, we want to see where's all the friendships. Yeah. No Amini. What does that mean, David?
David?
I want to know.
Wow.
Pastor Sammy's here.
Yes.
Repping Botany Campus. Love it.
First one,
cool
Botany.
How cool is it that we can all get together, even in these crazy times?
Yeah.
We can hop online, still hang out. It's good.
Crazy times. We can still stay together online. That's
right.
What it's all about.
Yeah.
Let's keep it happening.
Let's keep it going. And we are stoked that all 64 of you decided to join us tonight. It's going to be good. We have some epic things planned tonight.
Yep.
We've got some challenges. Some giveaways
as well. Yes, we've got a giveaway to give out tonight, so stay tuned.
It's going to be good. Make sure you're involved. So you're going to be wanting to practice your little fingers in the comments tonight, because to get that giveaway, you're going to have to be super
fast.
You're
going to be racing.
So
super fast onto there.
Hit us with your comments. Who else is here? We've got Levi Wooler. Hey, bro. Nice to have you with us. Who else is here?
Azon.
That's one of your boys.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh,
well,
wow.
He said he was from Mount Wellington.
Oh, did he? Okay, sorry. Azon, I'm not sure. I think it might be the Pastor Jacob's gaming boys.
Hey.
Azon. What's up, Azon?
Nice, yeah. Who else is here? We've got Kevin Cronier. We've got the twins in the house.
Nice.
JB on the track. I'm going to go with a guess that one's Joel.
Joel.
I feel like you have a hat that says Joel.
Okay, awesome. So I think we're going to go head into some worship tonight.
Yo.
And it's going to look a little different for you guys out there, but you may want to shout the lyrics. You may want to stand up and sing.
Yeah,
but
get on your feet.
We're going to praise Jesus tonight.
It's going to be good.
And we're going to take it away, Yvonne.
Woo.
Welcome, everyone. Thank you for joining us online tonight. We're super excited to have you here. Why don't we just get straight into praising God?
Colorless light, there's no hiding from your grace. I can't deny your heart for mine, and it's a relentless chase. I was on the edge of deception, caught up in my own hesitation, until your love took over me. Show me life like supposed to be. An oasis here awaits us. All the freedom I ever need. Now I'm.
good is the presence of God? How cool is it being able to worship over YouTube? Man, we are going to play a little game over here with some of our campus youth pastors. So we have pastors Nick and Holly from the North Shore campus. We have Pastor Falau and Lucy from our Mount Wellington campus represent. And we also have DT from our Westgate campus, West Side. And we're gonna play a little game we like to call Never Have I Ever Youth Pastor Edition. So I'm gonna ask these guys a couple of questions and they're gonna flip up on their signs whether they have or whether they never have. So, without a further ado, let's get into the questions. So guys, and answer honestly, never have I ever peed in the shower. Come on, show us. How humiliating. All right, next question. Never have I ever ridden in the back of a cop car. Surely guys, sure. Pastor Nicholas. Whoa, okay. Never have I ever double dipped. Now, if any of you say that you have, I'm judging you so hard because that is so gross. All right, show us. Well, Holly, absolute respect for that, honestly. Can't trust anyone. Never have I ever ghosted someone's text. Show of hands. Wow, I feel like some of you are lying over here. All right, never have I ever given a fake name. Show us. Ooh, some mixed answers going on over here. All right. Never have I ever Googled myself. What do you guys think about that one? Surely, surely. Never, never, Pastor Falau. Wow, okay. This one's a bit of a spicy one. Never have I ever dated my friend's ex. Ooh. Wow, a lot of nevers over here and I feel like people are lying. All right. Never have I ever got caught waving at someone who wasn't actually waving at you. How awkward. I hate that so much. All right. Never have I ever got caught checking myself out in a reflection. Never got caught? Never got caught. To clarify. All right. Never have I ever DM'd a celebrity crush. What would you even DM them? I don't even know. Hi? Okay, this one's a bit embarrassing. Never have I ever blocked a friend or public toilet. Oh, Lucy. Oh, DT. Well, okay. Never have I ever accidentally liked a crush's or your ex's post. Accidentally. Wow. Okay, these are getting spicy. Okay. Never have I ever used someone else's toothbrush. I feel like that's just plain gross, but I know that it happens. You know, it's just like the worst feeling. You're like, do I put extra Listerine in? Like at the start of the day when you realize halfway through the day, you can't go back and brush your teeth. You're at work now. You're at school. You can't go back from that. All right. Never have I ever stolen something from a store. Wow. Only you, Pastor Falau. Wow, awkward. Okay. Never have I ever been kicked out of a venue. Can't imagine why you would get kicked out of a venue, but Pastor Nick has. Do you want to care to share where you've been kicked out of before?
Sure, it was not my fault. It was on my brother's stag do, and I had nothing to do with it, but yeah, we got kicked out of a pub.
Wow, spicy youth pastors' lives. Okay, never have I ever picked my nose in public. Look, surely, maybe drop us in the comments. Have you picked your nose in public? You know, name and shame, show us. Make these guys feel a little bit better about, you know, sharing all of their stuff. So, last question. Never have I ever lied in this game. Well. Hilarious. All right, guys. Well, thanks for playing. And we're going to head and throw over to our challenge. So check that out. Thanks, team.
Hey, guys. My name is Manny.
I'm Jado.
And today we're doing the egg roulette challenge.
For the youth.
Yeah, we're doing it for you guys.
Hashtag FTY. You guys would have seen it on the last Instagram. Me and Andrew were eating the 100-year-old egg.
Yeah, how many of you guys thought that was disgusting? That was really disgusting.
It was delicious. No flashbacks, please. Please, thank you.
Okay, anyways. Explain the rules, Jada.
I think we grab an egg. So I think we've got one unboiled egg. And we're just going to be smashing it against each other's heads, egg roulette. And whoever gets the unboiled egg loses.
Okay, let's do this.
Sweet.
Shoot. Got it.
Ah!
Yeah, all right, I gotta pick.
You go first.
So whatever egg I touch, I can.
Whatever egg you touch, you need to pick, yeah.
Okay.
You also have the option to hit it on your own head.
Why would I want to do that?
So if you think it's solid or boiled, then you can have the safe option and hit it against your own head.
Nice.
Alright, let's see if...
Doing my hair and everything.
I feel, man. Yeah. You have to, with these gold long Goldilocks, you have to wash it.
Yeah.
Girls would know what I mean. I'm already getting flashbacks just because of the smell of the egg.
Why'd you have to hit so hard?
That wasn't hard, you hit it as well.
It was like... This was already cracked!
Might as well hit your own head with that.
Yeah,
one.
I was like, yeah.
Get it out of the way.
Sweet. Right. Can we eat it after?
This one. Hopefully it's the lucky one. Oh, well.
My hair is coming off. Look at that.
Man.
Oh, no.
I'm feeling nervous because the more and more the salt, the boiled ones we get.
Do you know this comes out of the chicken's bum?
Thanks for the reminder. Oh, that one hurt.
Sorry.
That's alright. Doing it for the youth. We're doing it for the youth.
Yeah.
Ready? 3, 2. Oh! No! It's solid!
I think.
4 more eggs left.
Well, 4 more eggs, guys. So. Yeah, I think this one's the right one.
I'm nervous, I'm so nervous. Alright.
It smells disgusting.
It does.
Yeah.
Alright. Oh! Going with this one. Going with this one. I think it's gonna go 50-50.
Yeah.
Here we go. Ready? Yeah. It's a boiled egg. Yeah. Boiled egg.
We got 2 more, guys. So if I get this last one and I get it right, do I get to win something?
No, we'll see. I think you just.
You guys should put down in the comments who you guys think.
I think it's just bragging rights. Bragging rights. Like, I didn't get an
if you guys think I'm gonna win, say money. If you don't think I'm gonna win, just
Jay.
Put money.
Put Jay. Jay. Let's go. Okay. Alright.
I don't think this one, but then I also want to put this one. Oh no, I feel bad now because now I picked it up and I know it's pretty heavy.
Oh no.
It's pretty heavy.
I mean, you could splash it on your own head if you want. If you think it's a solid one. But then I could just smash that one if it isn't.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, oh no.
There's the magic egg.
No! Alright, let's do it. You're killing me. Alright, do a countdown.
Like, in the middle of your head is red.
Yeah.
It's red, like, in the middle of your head.
Alright. Smells like egg.
Yeah,
all right.
It does, egg.
Okay, let's go.
Oh no, I'm not. Wait, hold on. What if all of them were all boiled?
We'll see.
What if you smash it on your head? I'll give you $100 afterwards.
I could smash it on my head, or I could take the sweet, sweet victory.
Wait, how many? 1, 2, 3.
9. We splashed 9 of them. You ready?
No.
We'll make it nice and quick.
What if they were all boiled? Like, what if the chef, like, forgot to, like, leave that one out?
I don't know, man, but I just know I'm gonna enjoy this. Taking 9 eggs to the head. Wait, no. Half. 5 eggs to the head. Ain't nice. You ready?
When they ask you if you're fine.
But you're not fine. You say you're fine, so no one asks any questions.
Okay,
you're up to you. All right. Here we go. 3, 2. Let's go for the youth. That's the egg roulette challenge from CIC Youth. See you guys this Friday.
See you guys.
Hey, I don't know what it is about our youth group, but we seem to have a mild obsession with egg challenge.
Egg challenge.
I love those guys. Yep. I was loving the comments of you guys blowing it up on who was going to win. But let's be honest, who loves seeing Minnie get it?
Oh, man. They need to have a good wash of their hair, eh, after that?
Yeah. Good. Get the good
stuff. Now we know what to get them for Easter.
Easter. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah. Wow. Okay, so I don't know if you guys saw our social media, but we are going to be talking about dreams tonight. And a couple of weeks ago, Pastor Peter shared a really awesome message all about having vision for the future, which is epic, especially in the times that we're in at the moment. Yeah. So we are going to check out a short clip from Pastor Peter. Thanks, team.
I just want to ask you a question today. What's in your lunchbox? What is in your lunchbox? How much vision do you have? How far can you see down the track? Because how far you can see is going to determine how far you can go. Can I say that again? How far you can see is going to determine how far you go. You know, I know a lot of people, young people, who are having their dreams robbed at this particular point of time with what's happening on the planet, this whole COVID thing, the riots and so forth, the state of the world right now. I mean, scholarships and travel and careers. So many young people seemingly have got their dreams being robbed. But can I encourage you to stay dreaming? Hallelujah. You know, everything comes to pass. Hallelujah. Things come to pass. Winter comes and spring begins to happen. We're coming out of winter very soon, and we're coming into spring, hallelujah, and then into summer in the natural, and seasons come and seasons go. And just because we're in this particular season right now with this whole COVID thing, the whole world, hold on to your dream. It will come to pass, hallelujah.
Oh, wow. You got to love Pastor Peter's heart, eh?
So
we've got a giveaway for that, and in order for you to win this, guys, look at this beauty. Oh, look at that. And it's also been hand-painted by our very own Alan Rath. Look at that.
Woo.
Look at that. When you're going down a hill with this, once they see this, you'll be famous as well.
That's
so
right.
We want to give this away, and it's going to be the very first person.
Yeah, we've got our eyes on the comments.
In the comments, the name of that message, the title of that message.
Go, go, go. What was the title of Pastor Peter's message?
Yep.
In the comments, right now, we're checking it out.
And then we'll announce the winners or the winner at the end.
Yeah, awesome.
Wow.
So we're checking out the comments. Right, love it, love it, love it. Oh, I see answers.
I see
answers, Pastor Philo. Look at
coming
in. But who was
that?
The fastest? That's the real question I think we're going to check out after the next segment, right?
After the next one.
Nice. Love it. All right, so keep your question answers coming in, and we are about to fire it over to Pastor Nick, who's got a little message for us.
I'm on. Yep. Hey, shout out to everyone who is tuning in tonight. So excited to be here with you. Drop your love in the comments for our amazing host, Holly and Falau. I'm so excited to be able to bring a short message to you tonight, to bring the word to you. And we've themed this night daydreams. And I don't know about you, I'm not actually much of a dreamer when I sleep. I was telling someone earlier today, they're like, what? When I go to bed, I go to sleep and then I wake up and that's it. So that's why I call this daydreams, because I do daydream. And I think a lot of us daydream, and I believe a lot of our daydreams are our innermost desires and dreams, and they come out in our thoughts. For me, sometimes it's when me and Holly are driving in the car, and she's just chatting away, and I'm just kind of off wandering in thought, daydreaming, and she goes, and what do you think? And I go, oh, yep. And it might be the same for you at school, in your classroom with your teachers. But we do wander off in thought about, you know, what are our plans for our life? What does our future look like? Maybe you wander off in thought about what you want to be when you're older. But tonight, I want to encourage you in the midst of the circumstance that we're in at the moment, this pandemic, I want to encourage you, young person, everybody tuning in right now, to continue to dream. Don't stop dreaming tonight just because everything around us is crazy. Don't be so consumed by what's going on right now that you forget to dream, young person. Don't forget to dream. And dream big. Think about your future. Don't be so consumed by what's going on right now. And before we get started, I just wanted to share a quick story about a dream that I had in my heart as a young person around your age. And ever since I was a little kid, I always thought that I would work in ministry. I didn't know what that looked like, but I always had a heart for God's house. And I remember I went for a guitar lesson. I was getting lessons from this guy, and I really respected him. And we sat down together for my guitar lesson. And we were just chatting away as you do. And he says, "What do you want to do when you're older?" And I was like, "Worship leader." But it turns out that you actually need to be able to sing to be a worship leader. It's not just the heart of worship. But I said to him, "You know what? I'd love to go to Hillsong College and, you know, learn about ministry and what that looks like." And he says to me, and I don't think in a kind of mean way, he just says, "Bro, you don't need to do that to do something great for God. Man, it's so overrated going there. You don't need to do that." And he kind of went on for a bit, and I was kind of sitting there like, and I was in about 13 or 14 years old. And man, he just kind of like, I was feeling so bummed. He kind of shattered my dream a little bit there in that moment. And I kind of just went off a bit like, well, if I don't do that because it's kind of overrated, then I'm not really sure what I'm going to do. And I'm not going to blame him for the decisions I made in the years later, but by the end of my high school years, I wasn't walking with God anymore, and my life had kind of gone off track. And that dream I had once in my heart was there, but I wasn't sure what I was meant to do. And I kind of just tried a bunch of things and ended up being a builder, moved here to Auckland. Turns out there's a lot of work, but I never really wanted to move to Auckland, but I believe it was God's plan for my life because it brought me back into his house where I ended up giving my life to God again. And here I am sharing the word with you tonight. So God is a great redeemer of your dreams. If you feel like your dream has been lost, God can redeem your dream tonight and in your future. Amen. And I believe each and every one of you has a dream that you're called by God. You're called for such a time as this. And I love to speak to two people tonight, those who have a dream and those who don't have a dream. You feel a little bit lost right now. Maybe you're scared about the exams that are coming up and you're not really sure what your future's going to look like. And whether you're either of these two people, I'd love to encourage you with a scripture. It'll come up the bottom there, Matthew 6, verse 33. And I believe this should always be your response. Whether you're either of those people, seek first the kingdom of God and above, seek first the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and he will give you everything you need. Whether you have a dream in your heart, whether you're a bit lost at the moment, seek first the kingdom of God above all else, and he will give you everything you need. I'm just going to pray quick before we continue. Father, I thank you for tonight. And Lord, as we gather around your word, Father, I pray that, Lord, our hearts would be open to receive from you. Holy Spirit, I pray that you would do what only you can do and do a work in our hearts tonight. I pray that you would ignite dreams tonight, Father, in the hearts of every young person tuning in right now. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, to those with a dream, I want to share this scripture with you. It's in Ephesians 3, verse 20. It says, "Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than we ask or imagine, according to his power at work within us, to him be the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus through all generations, forever and ever. Amen." And young person tonight, I want to encourage you that whatever's on your heart, whatever that dream is, God is able to do more than you could ever have imagined. I heard that this week somebody said that God starts at the end of your imagination. God can do exceedingly more than you could ever have asked for or imagined. But there's a key in that scripture, and it is, according to his power that is at work within us. See, we got to leave room for God to work within us. I see a lot of people chasing dreams, and God's on the sideline. He's kind of just sitting there like, yeah, that's cool. A lot of people chasing dreams without leaving room for God to do immeasurably more than they imagine. And sure, some people might succeed at their dreams. But you see a lot of famous people succeeding at their dreams, but they lack joy, they lack purpose. See, that purpose for us as Christians is that we've been found in Christ, we've been given this message of reconciliation to the world. There's something so much greater in Christ with your dreams. So leave room for God in your dreams. Do it alongside Him. Don't do it alone. And see, you're not just signing up for a career. It was so cool to see on our Instagram this week all the different careers and dreams that people have in their hearts. But I want to encourage you tonight that you're not just signing up for a career, but a life with Christ makes it so much more exciting, so much more interesting. See, if you let Him, if you let God move within you, if you give Him room to do that, if you dream with Him, see, God will use you to change your workplace. You won't just be going in to be a doctor or a lawyer or a tradie or whatever it is on your heart that you would like to do. God will use you if you let Him to change your workplace. So you could change the world one heart at a time, but you got to leave room for God. And I love what the Bible says. It says, we no longer live for ourselves, but for Christ who gave Himself for us. See, I don't believe that your dream is just for you. See, I believe in Christ, your dream is for the benefit of others. What you put your hand to, if you do it in Christ, will benefit others. So I encourage you, young person, that you would pray and ask God to use you in your chosen field. Whatever your dream may be, ask God to use you. And I'd also like to say, whatever you choose as a career, whatever your dream is for the future, we have dreams in different seasons, I believe, and sometimes that dream will change. So don't believe that whatever you pick right now is going to be the end. I love that Paul in the Bible, he was a tent maker, yet at the same time he was doing amazing things for God. He was changing the world. So keep an open mind, young person, on God's call for your life. Don't shut Him out. Don't just say, I'm doing this and that's it. Would you invite God in to dream with you? Again, for people that have a dream, trust God. Trust the process. It says in Romans 5 that perseverance produces character. And right now, I'd love to encourage you not to give up on your dream. I know in the circumstance where it is at the moment, it might be easy just to kind of throw it out the window. There's no motivation to do anything great. But I'd love to encourage you, don't give up on your dream. Persevere through these hard times. And persevere when your dream doesn't look like the way you think it's meant to be going right now. If it doesn't look like you're on the right track. Because I've been there. That was me when I was 18 years old. I didn't know where I was going. I had that dream in my heart, but I was a little bit lost. But if you put God first, if you seek Him with all your heart, I believe that He will lead and guide you into that dream that He's placed on your heart, into your calling. And also, I'd love to encourage you, don't give up on God if your dream hasn't come to pass yet. See, a lot of people just dropping God when things aren't going their way and they try to do it on their own. But I'd love to encourage you tonight, young person, don't give up on your dream and don't give up on God, because He's there with you. He's the one working through you to fulfill His purpose and His calling for your life. And to those without a dream tonight, don't worry. You're not weird. You don't lack anything. I just believe you haven't found God's calling for your life yet. And again, I say to you, Matthew 6:33, seek first the kingdom of God. If you don't know what career you're meant to take, if you're a little bit lost in life right now, seek first the kingdom of God. And let God show you what you're meant to be doing. It's almost easier that way that God would show you what you're meant to be doing. And I believe God has an amazing calling on your life. And maybe tonight
You're thinking, I don't really have anything to offer, and that's why I'm a little bit lost. There's a story in Judges 6 of a man named Gideon. And see, Gideon didn't see himself as anything great. He said, I'm the least of my tribe. I'm like the least of the least. Yet God had an amazing calling on his life. See, he didn't see the greatness that he hid inside him, but God saw that greatness. And I want to tell you tonight that God sees the greatness that is within you. And he's going to draw that purpose out when you seek him with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, as you seek first the kingdom of God. If you don't have a dream tonight, do that. Seek first the kingdom of God, and I believe that God will draw those things out of you, that greatness that is within you, young person. And I want to say tonight that every single young person has greatness in them. I love what it says as we come to a close in Philippians 1, verse 6. It says, and I am certain that God, who began a good work within you, will continue his work until it is finally finished on the day when Christ returns. See, I'm certain that what God has started in you, maybe he's placing a dream on your heart right now, maybe he'll place a dream on your heart tonight, but what God is starting within you, he is faithful to fulfill it. He is faithful to finish it until our very last days. See, young person, God has a plan and a purpose for your life. So I'd love to encourage you tonight to dream big. Pray big prayers. Don't just settle for a career. Don't just settle for a job, but dream big. Ask God what he's calling you to do. Seek him first. Seek his kingdom first. And that doesn't mean that you can't be a businessman or do whatever is on your heart, but seek his kingdom first and ask him, you know, if that is the way for me, Lord, what can I do for you in that career? What can I do for you with my life? Don't just settle for mediocre, but settle for the kingdom of God. Seek first the kingdom of God. And I'm just going to pray real quick. I hope you've been encouraged. And then I'm going to hand it over back to our host. But let me just pray first. Father, I just thank you for every young person, Lord God, every person under the sound of my voice right now. Lord, I pray that you would ignite dreams tonight, Father, in the hearts of our young people. Lord, as we seek first your kingdom, Lord, I pray that you would lead and guide us, Father, as your word says, that we wouldn't lean not on our own understanding, but we would trust in you. Lord, we thank you for what you're doing tonight, igniting dreams in young people. Lord, we love you. We thank you for what you did on the cross for us. Lord, bless every young person right now. I pray your favor over their lives, Lord God, that they would be world changers, dominion takers, as it says in our school creed, that you would change the world, young person. Dream big. In Jesus' name. All right, we're going to hand it back to our amazing hosts. Thanks, everyone.
Wow, how hot was that message?
So good. How hot was the preacher?
Yep. Oh, wow, we're going there, right? We're going there. On that note, we've got a winner for the skate.
Yeah.
Skate, what was it?
Skate deck.
Skate deck. I'm not used to it. Back in our days, I had a little tricycle, so I wasn't really used to kind of running skateboards.
Yeah, has a tricycle.
So that's why, forgive me, guys, I didn't get the name right. But we have a winner. We have a winner. Okay,
who is it?
The winner is Satin Kim.
Woo!
Satin Kim. We know you're watching.
Coming out to you, Satin.
Coming out to you.
That's right. You can put some wheels on there, go bomb some hills, or you could just, like Pastor Nick Nutt does with his skateboards, just put it in the house as some art.
Some art. There you go.
It's by an artist, so I feel like it's worth trillions.
You can do all of the above.
So good. Hey, what an epic night we have had.
Yep.
But it is not over. We have a few cool things to share with you. So first off, I don't know if you saw our social media, but we have some pretty epic news to announce.
That's right.
So in the middle of January, we've never done this before, Pastor Fulham.
No, we haven't.
We are taking youth camp to an island.
Come on.
So it's going to be epic. So it's going to be a split camp, juniors and seniors. You're going to have your own time on the island. It's going to be across a whole week.
Could even be climbing some coconuts on the island, eh? Hey, you islands.
Maybe. Bring a straw.
Bring a straw.
It's going to be epic. And we've got more details coming for you after this live. So make sure you're tuning into our social media. But it's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
I am so excited.
Me too. I can't wait for it.
It's going to be so good.
Counting down the days.
That's right. Middle of January.
Middle
Put it in your diary
January.
Now. Save the date.
That's right. So what an awesome night we've had, eh?
So
just
good.
Before we end off, we've got a couple of notices that we want to remind you all.
Yeah.
Don't sleep in on Sunday morning, guys.
Right.
We've got our Sunday morning services happening at 10 a.m.
Yeah.
Always pumping. And also after that, we've got junior high.
Yes.
That's
Straight
been awesome,
after
eh?
the morning service is junior high.
Yep.
It's going to be
epic.
We've been having such a good time online.
Yes, we've
so
also
good.
Has even the prizes. They're loving the Uber Eats. Say, I think they want more of that.
I feel like everyone loves a good food prize.
Yes.
Are they your favorite type of prizes? What else could we do? Maybe check as a comment, some suggestions
for
prizes that are like obviously
Don't
doable
go too expensive.
Over this. Yeah, we can't fly you to Fiji. I'm sorry.
Sorry.
That's good.
No worries at all. Okay, what do we have next?
I feel like that's it.
Yeah.
Oh,
don't forget
after
that.
This, we are Almost jumping forgot. Into our Pack the House groups, fan fave.
Yep.
So make sure you guys get onto your chats with your leaders. And I'm sure they've already been in contact with you, but we're hopping into our Pack the House groups after this for some small group time, which is going to be amazing.
Then continue talking about the message, the awesome message that
How
Pastor
good
Nick.
Was that, eh?
Yeah.
So good. Dream big, youth.
Yep.
Dream big.
That's
I love it. But that's all for us this week.
All.
But maybe you'll see us next week. Who knows?
Don't forget to subscribe.
Yep. Press
subscribe.
The notification bell so that you can get notified when we go live.
Yep.
7 p.m. every Friday.
Put
it in diary. It's going to be great.
More games, more giveaways.
Yeah. It's going to be good.
Yep.
So
and
make
spread
sure
the word.
Yeah. Awesome. We'll see you guys later.
Bye.
We are City Impact Youth. We believe Jesus is for everyone. We will do whatever it takes to see our generation saved. We are fearless in living out our purpose. We love God. We love people. This is our generation. This is our mission. This is our time.